Hi, my name is Melanie and welcome back to our channel. Today our topic will be once again temporal interference. In one of our recent videos, we have presented to you the TI planning tool. Since this is also highly relevant to what I will be showing you today, I recommend you to watch that video after this one. Today I will present to you the device standing in front of me and how it can be programmed to execute a variety of experiments. It is the TIBS-R and its just released software version 1.02. TIBS-R stands for Temporal Interference Brain Stimulator for Research. In the following, we will have a look into the different features of this novel device. It is produced by TI Solutions AG. This system is a high-precision, high-quality, high-bandwidth 8-channel intelligent current source. It enables researchers to do high-quality temporal interference experiments with human subjects, with animals, or in vitro. Temporal interference is a recently introduced non-invasive brain stimulation technique that is able to target deep brain structures without activating overlaying ones. TI stimulation involves applying at least 2 currents in the kilohertz range with slightly different frequencies via scalp electrodes. Where the 2 currents overlap in the brain, they generate an electric field modulated at a different frequency, which can influence neural activity, whereas the pure kilohertz-only carrier cannot. You can see this principle nicely demonstrated in the image in the paper here. Specifications of the TIBS-R are available online at www.temporalinterference.com. The device includes several hardware-defined safety limits and is designed to work in conjunction with a variety of other experimental electric equipment. It can even be used in an MRI scanner. TIBS-R comes with a flexible and powerful API in Python and MATLAB for controlling the device. Complex study protocols can as such be implemented very easily. For today, I have implemented a graphical user interface for a 4-channel experiment that makes use of our experimental validation phantom and also of the 2 external hardware triggers. Now let us quickly have a look at the simulations we conducted in Sim4Life to see what we would expect from this experiment and so that we can also compare the results in the end. Here, we can see the validation phantom. We know that using 1 channel leads to highest exposure near the electrodes. We can see this nicely here in the field distribution. 2 channels are able to focus stimulation on a deep target localized where the volume currents of the 2 channels overlap. Again, here we see the different field distribution of such a setup. The TI volume is like a shoulder here. In other words, the focality is limited. If we activate the 4 channels, however, the focality can be very much improved, as visible in this 3rd field distribution. Similarly, the focus can also be improved with the same concept in human or animal heads, as TIBS-R offers up to 8 channels. In this experiment with 4 channels, we will further make use of our external hardware triggers to control the experiment with external input signals. With the first trigger, the amplitude of the current output can be ramped up and down respectively. With the second trigger, we can switch between sham exposure, where there is no difference in frequency between the 2 fields, and the TI exposure, where we then have our slight difference. For this experiment, I will use these triggers as an input and activate the buttons by hand. However, the idea is that in a real-world setting, these triggers are inputs coming from an external event. This can be electro or magnetoencephalography events, or even an eye tracker. To start the experiment, of course, first of all, we would have to connect all the electrodes. However, not to bore you with that, I have prepared this already. Next, I have implemented a little impedance check that can be used to control if the connections of the electrodes are all well established. After choosing the amount of channels in use and setting up the other parameters, I start it and it performs a frequency sweep. Now that the cross impedance check is completed, we can switch over to the data charts to see the evaluation of the current amplitude over time and visualize the impedance spectra as impedance charts. We can see that all the impedances are stable in the entire frequency range from 1 to 100 kHz, and they are less than 2 kilo-ohms. In other words, all the electrodes are well mounted. Once we have verified that the electrodes are in good contact, we can start the actual experiment. First, we need to set up the parameters that the two triggers we saw before should be controlling. As we said before, trigger 1 will control the amplitudes and trigger 2 the frequency. The first pair of electrodes is set to 2 kHz and the second one to 5 kHz with a 20 Hz difference. And for the current, we choose 0 and 3 milliamps. On the left side of the screen, we can see the actual output of the device. In the top, we see the four channels and their individual electric field waveforms. Next to that, we can see the envelope generated by these four individual fields. Below, we have different graphs that give us an overview of the field current, the voltage, impedance, and finally of the frequency. After we have set up everything, we can now hit start on the user interface and the TIBS-R is ready to commence the experiment. Using trigger 1, I am now able to ramp up the current output of the device, and we can see this nicely represented here in the graph. I will now use trigger 2 to switch between the sham and the TI exposure, as we talked about before. Again, we see the reaction in the graphical user interface, especially nicely in the changes that we see in the envelope, because now we can actually see the TI envelope that we discussed. I will switch back to sham exposure, and once we finish the experiment, we can ramp down the current output and finally hit stop on our interface. Let's have a look at our experimental results measured in our dosimetric lab with our new Cobra probe and compare them to the simulations that we showed in the beginning. Here we can see the measurement results and the evaluated TI distributions, and we see beautifully how well these agree with the simulations that we have done before. Today, I have shown you a rather simple experiment. However, with TIBS-R, millions of much more complex protocols can be flexibly implemented. Furthermore, The API allows you to fully automate the device in any conceivable workflow that you choose. If we piqued your interest and you would like to adopt TIBS-R for your investigational studies, then please apply for our early adopters program by simply writing us an email at eap@temporalinterference.com. I hope today's video gave you an informative glimpse at the capabilities of this amazing new device. Of course, we put all the relevant website and email addresses in the description box down below. If you like today's video, then please smash that like button to let us know. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so that you never miss out on any of the new developments or demonstrational videos that will surely be posted here again. Thank you so much for dropping by, and I wish you a really nice day. Bye!